Hello and welcome to World Watch on Oweleke TV. I am Anthonia Mokolo. The boss of Southwest Water says she's truly sorry for the outbreak of a diarrhea-type illness in South Devon. A total of 22 cases of cryptosporidiosis was confirmed in Brixham by UKHSA on Wednesday, with more than 100 people having reported symptoms to their GP in the last week. SWW said it believed it had located the source where the parasite could have made its way into the water network on Thursday. CEO Suzanne Davy said the company would not stop working until the situation has been resolved. The House on Thursday passed a Republican-led bill to condemn President Joe Biden's approach to Israel and force him to send arms shipments to the U.S. ally. The final vote was 224 to 187. 16 Democrats voted for the bill, going against House Democratic leadership and President Biden. The measure is a culmination of the political fallout from Biden's recent pause of a bomb shipment to Israel and his pointed warning. The U.S. won't supply weapons that could be used in an invasion of Rafah, a city in southern Gaza where more than a million civilians have sought shelter. Republicans have seized on the actions to attack Biden, accusing him of betraying Israel due to political pressure. The White House and many Democrats have countered that the GOP-led bill is misleading and distorts Biden's policy on the Israel-Hamas war. In other news, the United States military has started delivering aid to Gaza. CNN reports that trucks carrying humanitarian aid into Gaza have begun moving ashore after arriving through the floating pier built by the U.S. military. According to the report, the pier was anchored to a beach in Gaza on Thursday and will be used to funnel aid from various countries into the besieged strip. With all other border crossings closed and a catastrophic humanitarian disaster unfolding inside, the U.S., which began building the 320 million pier in late April, has emphasized it is a temporary measure that is entirely humanitarian in nature and will involve aid commodities donated by some countries and humanitarian organizations. Canada's Prime Minister Justin Trudeau is scheduled to visit a school in Winnipeg today to promote his government's school nutrition program. The government's spring budget included a promise to develop a national plan to provide meals to 400,000 more kids across the country. The cost is estimated at $1 billion over 5 years. Manitoba's NDP government has promised $30 million for school meal programs this year. The Prime Minister touted his government spending plans, including new dental care, expanded child care, and coverage for insulin. Despite ongoing deficits, he said Canada's fiscal situation is better than that of other large developed countries. And that's all we have for you on World Watch. I am Anthonia Mwokolo.
Follow us on our social media handles at Oweleke TV. Visit our website at www.oweleke.tv for a thrilling journey. Oweleke TV, rising star at the fairground.